Glucagon is secreted by pancreatic alpha cells in response to decrease in blood glucose level. To explain the mechanism of glucagon secretion, we have to know a few basic concepts. As we know, potassium is intracellular ion. This means that concentration of potassium inside the cell is much higher than potassium concentration outside the cell. And calcium is extracellular ion, so calcium concentration outside the cell much higher than inside the cell. Alpha cells on their membranes have ATP-sensitive potassium channels, also they have voltage-gated calcium channels, also they have vesicles that have already formed glucagon molecules, and they have a GLUT1 transporter that transports glucose from the blood into the cell. So when glucose enters through a GLUT1 transporter into the alpha cells, glucose gets phosphorylated by glucokinase and undergo glycolysis with subsequent degradation in Krebs cycle and electron transport chain that results in production of ATP molecules. And it's the most crucial step. First of all, glucose-1 transporter provides transportation of glucose inside the cell in proportionate amounts to glucose level in the blood. So for example, for every 10 glucose molecules in the blood, GLUT1 transporter transports 2 glucose molecules. And for every 30 glucose molecules in the blood, GLUT1 transporter transports 6 glucose molecules. So the higher the glucose level in the blood, the higher will be glucose income into the cell. And the reason why alpha cells have glucokinase to work as energy sensor is that the activity of glucokinase is not inhibited by glucose-6-phosphate. So this permits alpha cells to phosphorylate all glucose molecules to glucose-6-phosphate at the same time. And by amount of ATP molecules produced, alpha cells can determine changes in blood glucose level. For example, if for every 10 glucose molecules, GLUT1 transporter transports 2 glucose molecules into the cell, then all 2 glucose molecules get phosphorylated in the same time, and this results in production of, for example, 72 ATP molecules. So let's assume that normal blood glucose level produces 72 ATP molecules per minute. And now a cell can determine what is the level of glucose in the blood in various conditions. Because if the amount of ATP per minute decreases to 36 ATP molecules, then blood glucose level is 2 times lower than normal, so we have hypoglycemia. And if the amount of ATP becomes 144, then blood glucose level is 2 times higher than normal, so we have hyperglycemia. The overall concept of glucagon secretion is that glucagon is secreted by exocytosis. To trigger exocytosis, cell requires high intracellular calcium level. To create high intracellular calcium level, voltage-gated calcium channels have to open. And in the rest state, they are closed. Because calcium channels are voltage-gated, they are opened by cellular depolarization. And as we know, depolarization is the state when membrane potential increases. Membrane potential at rest is -70. And to increase membrane potential, the amount of intracellular positively charged ions inside the cell have to increase. And we see that alpha cells have potassium channels. So the way to increase the amount of positively charged ions is to increase the amount of potassium inside the cell. Potassium is intracellular ion, and because potassium concentration inside the cell is greater than potassium concentration outside the cell, if this channel is in open state, potassium is going out of the cell. So to secrete glucagon, potassium level inside the cell has to increase. This means that these potassium channels have to be closed, and these potassium channels are called ATP sensitive, because changes in ATP level inside the cell determine the functional state of this potassium channel. And with decrease in ATP, potassium channels close, and with increase in ATP, potassium channels open. And there are 2 scenarios. In case of hyperglycemia, if blood glucose level is high, then high amount of glucose enter into the cell, and this results in production of high amount of ATP molecules. And high amount of ATP molecules induce opening of ATP-sensitive potassium channels. Overall, if we compare insulin secretion with glucagon secretion, they are very similar, with one huge exception. In insulin secretion, increase in ATP level triggers closure of potassium channels. In case of glucagon, increase in ATP triggers opening of potassium channels. And by keeping potassium channels in open state, potassium is going out of the cell by concentration gradient. Potassium ions have positive charge, and the more potassium ions leave the cell, the less positively charged ions remains inside the cell. And with decreasing amount of positively charged ions inside the cell, membrane potential goes down, for example from -70 to -80. thereby cells become hyperpolarized, and in hyperpolarized state, calcium channels cannot be activated, thereby there will be no induction of exocytosis, and in this case, glucagon secretion is impossible. And in case of hypoglycemia, if blood glucose level is low, then the amount of glucose that enters through GLUT1 transporter is low, thereby the amount of ATP produced by the cell is low. And in this case, the low amount of ATP molecules induce closure of potassium channels. So potassium channels close, thereby intracellular potassium increase, and with increasing amount of positively charged ions, membrane potential increase, for example from minus 70 to minus 50. And state when membrane potential becomes more positive, we call depolarization. So cell depolarize, and depolarization activates voltage-sensitive calcium channels. Calcium channels open, and calcium is going into the cell. Increasing intracellular calcium level triggers exocytosis of glucagon vesicles, and glucagon is released into the blood. In terms of glucagon regulation, we have to know that the major stimuli for glucagon secretion is decreasing blood glucose level. And the factor that decreases glucagon secretion is hyperglycemia. But the second factor that decreases glucagon secretion is insulin. Insulin affects the sensitivity of potassium channels. To explain this, let's take initially a hyperglycemic state. So in case of blood glucose level is high, blood insulin level is high, and alpha cells have insulin receptor. And insulin acts on alpha cells and basically helps to open potassium channels. The way to look at this is that without insulin to keep potassium channels open, cell has to produce 50 ATP molecules. In the presence of insulin, even 5 ATP molecules will be enough to keep them open. So insulin helps to lower this ATP level threshold for potassium channels activation. And in activated state, potassium channels open, and potassium is going out of the cell by concentration gradient, with decreasing intracellular positively charged ions, membrane potential goes down, for example from minus 70 to minus 80, thereby cell hyperpolarize, and in hyperpolarized state, calcium channels cannot be activated, thereby glucagon cannot be secreted. So hyperglycemia that causes high intracellular ATP level, together with insulin effect, open potassium channels, and by this, they inhibit glucagon release. The interesting case in diabetes type 1. The problem in diabetes type 1 is that insulin level is low, and because of that, tissues cannot trap glucose, so blood glucose level is high. So in case of diabetes type 1, there is paradoxically high blood glucose level and low insulin level. High amount of glucose molecules enter into the alpha cells and undergo glycolysis that results in production of high amount of ATP molecules. But because insulin level is very low, even the production of great amount of ATP molecules is not sufficient to keep potassium channels in open state for a prolonged period of time. And if potassium channels are closed, potassium ions remain inside the cell, membrane potential increase, cell depolarize, depolarization activates calcium channels open, calcium goes into the cell and induce exocytosis of glucagon into the blood. So in diabetes type 1, despite hyperglycemia, potassium channels cannot remain in open state for a prolonged period of time because of low insulin level, and this results in a paradoxically high glucagon level during hyperglycemia.